This is what the NIME Analytics platform looks like when you open it for the first time. It includes a number of default visual and background settings. In this video, we will take a tour of such default settings and we will see how we can customize them in such a way to make NIME Analytics platform more respondent to our visual and technical needs. So let's start from the workflow editor. The grid that you see here has a 20 pixel times 20 pixel cells. If you prefer to work with a finer or a coarser grid, click this button here. The window for the workflow editor settings opens. The first three options are for the grid. Show the grid lines, first of all, and then snap nodes to the grid when moving them around. Below is the option for the grid size. So if you prefer cells 10 by 10 instead of 20 by 20, you will need to change this setting here. So for example, and this is the result. Again, below the grid options, there are the node connection options. If you prefer curved or thicker connections, you need to change these settings here. For example, if we want curved connection and we want them 3 pixel thick, then we change these settings here, and this is the result. Now, remaining in the visual settings, let's explore the possible views. Additional view panels besides the console, the outline, the node repository, the workflow coach, the NIME Explorer, and the node description can be found under Item View in the top menu. For example, the NIME.log view shows the warnings and errors that have been triggered during the execution of your workflow. The item Other takes you to a number of other NIME views. If you are using NIME Commercial Product, the Licenses view might be useful to see what valid licenses you have. Server History and Server Recycle Bin might be useful for workflow versioning and backup on the mounted NIME servers. The Node Monitor view allows you to monitor the execution of a node. The Node Comparison view allows you to compare the settings of two different nodes. The node comparison view requires a NIME license. If, for whatever reason, your perspective is completely messed up, your last resource is this option, View Reset Perspective. And this option will take you back to the original configuration of view panels and workflow editor of the NIME Analytics platform. Let's move on now on how to change the default technical settings. Most of the default technical settings are stored under File Preferences, and most of them are stored under NIME in the Preferences window. In general, you can set whether to show the memory status of NIME by enabling this option here. If you enable the Show Heap Status option, you are going to see here how much memory is used by NIME when executing a workflow. Let's check the other preferences now. NIME. Under Databases, you can change the database default settings. You can add a DB driver file or increase the timeout for the connection of the database. This timeout number in seconds should, for example, be increased when dealing with big data platforms. If you are working with Spark and you don't want to create a new context, you can go into the NIME Big Data extension, Spark, and you can specify here whether to automatically create a new context every time that the NIME Analytics platform starts. NIME Explorer mounts additional NIME servers into the NIME Explorer panel. And here, under the NIME GUI and then Workflow Editor, we find the grid options again. In the NIME Store option, you can set the credentials for the NIME Store. After that, we have a number of options for the settings of some NIME integrations, like the OpenStreetMap, the MATLAB scripting, Palladian integration, Perl, Python, R, TIBCO, Selenium, and so on, depending on the extensions that you have installed. In text processing, you can specify the search engines to use for the links in the view produced by the NIME Viewer node. Finally, in Workflow Coach, you can define whether you want to receive the next node recommendation based on the community data and how frequently. This is the default configuration. Or if you want to receive your next recommendation based on some server data or some local workspace data. These two options require a NIME license to be activated. Here, we terminate this quick tour of what you might be interested in customizing in your NIME Analytics platform.